You must have heard about this. It was all over the internet. Adobe introduced a new AI feature. This cutting-edge tool analyzes every pixel of an image using AI to match lighting, perspective, coloring, and shadows. It can effortlessly fill, edit, and remove image elements with just a few clicks. Of course, I tested it myself. I took one of my vacation photos and transformed it to look like a business trip. After I posted it, the response was just amazing. Over 400,000 likes and more than 4.5 million views. I even created a fake room for myself and it looked so realistic. In the middle of a tiring day, I took a moment to lie down and rest, and this question popped into my head. Why don't we use this AI tool for Unreal Engine? Okay, here's the plan. I'm gonna create a draft scene, nothing complicated. It should be a simple and not time-consuming. But this draft scene needs to be detailed enough to fit the AI, because it's gonna fill out the environment. After a bit of digging, I decided to use a knight, maybe a tougher one, who enjoys gazing into the distance, a cool character. The rest were just a few rocks from mega scans, maybe a rotten tree, some clouds, and the sky. Nothing fancy. I'm gonna render the necessary area, not the entire draft scene. This will cut down my rendering time and make the workflow more efficient. The render is done, and here is the first frame of my video. I'm gonna import it into Photoshop Beta and make the canvas pretty big, like 12K resolution. Because I wanna add a zoom effect in my video, and having a big canvas will help me do that. The whole area you see will be filled in by AI, and the only thing I need to do is use the right prompts. Let's do it. It's done. Let's save it first, then import it into a video editing software. It could be Premiere Pro, After Effects, DaVinci or any other software that can do masking. The software doesn't matter really, just use what you have. Video editing part is super simple. I will take my video, put it on the AI generated image, and create a basic mask. That's it, really. The color corrections and zoom effects are just extra elements, like spices that add a little something special. But overall, it's such a simple workflow, and here is the final result. Last month, I posted my very first tutorial video and shared the impressive stats of my channel. That first video got more than 10,000 views, and my subscriber count increased by 550% to 325. Yes. Now, this is my second video, and I know these numbers might seem low, but I've got this feeling that One day my YouTube channel will hit tens of thousands of subscribers. When that day comes, it's gonna be wonderful to look back at these old days. They will be good memories. That's why I'm sharing all this with you. Thanks for watching. If you had a good time or learned something new, the subscribe button is waiting for you. If you have any questions, thoughts, or feedback, feel free to drop them in the comment section. See you in the next one.